yeah. Ooh, you always going out your way.
Certain artists started glorifying drug culture and Future. Doing drugs, and I ain't gonna blame Future. Who's the first rapper you heard popping pills?
Eminem. In fact, his first CD had a drawing of a pill, like being broken in half. Like
I idolize Snoop. We smoke weed.
Right.
All this pill popping generation. I idolize E-40. We sell drugs. We don't take them.
Yeah, it's true. It went from the drug dealers to the drug users.
What Cube and Biggie say? They both said the same thing. Don't get high on your own supply.
Yeah.
Can I get in it? Can I get in it? Oh, yeah. Back with another video, guys, letting you know what's going on. And Nick Cannon was in an interview today basically saying how he feel. Well, basically, Nick Cannon didn't say it, but he approved of the message. Basically saying that Eminem started the pill popping music. You see what I'm saying? And see, they always want to put it on us. Like, we always starting something. You know what I'm saying? Even though they know we did. And I'm not taking nothing away from Eminem, bro. Like, he one of the hardest, like, lyricists that can go to this day. You know what I'm saying? I'm not taking that from his talent. Real talk. I'm not taking nothing from his talent. But, bro, like I said, when he first came in the game, and I'm talking about my generation, I'm talking about me. When Eminem first came in the game, he was the first one that introduced me to that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I remember when Eminem first came out, I don't know what album it was, but he had a pill, broken up pill on his album cover. You get what I'm saying? So, but they want to always say, well, Future started it or Future did this. No, bro. Future didn't start. Man, this been here. You see what I'm saying? Because we gotta understand like this, man. These drugs, and y'all already know, we just allowed Juice WRLD not too long ago. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying they told Eminem to push this agenda, or it could have been something that he was just going through at the time. You know what I'm saying? But these drugs that we take, bro, and then on top of that, they put it in the music. So music is already strong. So when you put drugs into the music, what you think they gonna do? Everybody gonna want to do it because we live in a monkey see, monkey do reality. If you do something and everybody think you cool, I want to do it because I want to fit in. Not knowing that, hey man, one day this mic can cause me to die. You know what I'm saying? This mic can cause my life to be gone. That's how serious it is. You know what I'm saying? So, of course, if y'all want to call them the elites, I'm going to say high executive in the music business. Of course, they want this to be out there. Of course they want to push this. Of course they want us to, you know what I'm saying, to pop pills and, you know what I'm saying, go crazy with it. They looking for us to do this. You know what I'm saying? Even if Eminem looked at it like, man, I'm trying to find a way out. He probably was looking to trying to find a way out. You feel what I'm saying? But it paid a major price because look how many people are dying over it now. See, one thing about drugs, when you take drugs, man, you don't feel it then. It could be 5 or 6 years down the road, then you can start feeling it. You know what I'm saying? That's what's so crazy about drugs, bro. Real talk. And it's a sad thing that, you know, we had to lose Juice WRLD like that. Rest in peace. Not just Juice WRLD, but a lot of people, bro. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people. I know Meek Mill was in the interview talking about how he was on it. Like, bro, this is very real, bro. Like, but we don't take it serious because when you get somebody to come out and say, man, I got a problem or I pop pill, you got people that want to laugh at them. You dig me? You got people want to laugh at them. And that's why this world can't get no help, bro, because we always got people want to be so cool to point the finger at the person that needs the help. You see what I'm saying? Instead of just really helping this person. Because just like I just said, our music alone, bro, I look like music is a drug in itself. That the most powerful is drug. Because guess what? Music got people killing each other, taking drugs, doing everything. You see what I'm saying? So it's very spiritual, bro. So but the media plays it so good. The media play it so good, you wouldn't even think that they playing mind games on you. You'll think that it's okay. You know what I'm saying? Eminem also was the first artist to talk about killing his mama. If y'all want to be technical, if y'all want to be real about it, wasn't nobody talking about that. You know what I'm saying? We were more of the conscious route before, you know, NWA came on there. You know what I'm saying? But they really were just saying what they was going through. You know what I'm saying? But they also said the record label wanted them to rap a certain type of way and rapped about it. They really were just trying to tell us what they was going through. Like Nick said, we were just smoking weed. We weren't popping no pill. And if we were selling drugs, we sure weren't taking them. So you can't put that on us to make us feel like it's our fault what's going on. Because at the end of the day, we follow something. Everybody follows something in this world. You know what I'm saying? Everybody follows something. Everybody get up and want to be like something. Might want to be like somebody. Might be a better you. You want to be like something. You know what I'm saying? So when people be like, bro, that don't affect me and peer pressure not real. Yeah, it is. Peer pressure is very real, bro. It's very real, bro. Eminem had everybody doing that. Eminem, definitely the little white kids. Bro, they love Eminem. And like I said, the black kids was on them too. I used to listen to them. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, you cannot take nothing from his talent, dog. Like, you can't take nothing from Eminem's talent, though. Real talk. But when you be technical and you want to be real and you want to stay facts, you got to go to the source. You got to find out where it really came from. And when you find out where it really came from, you're going to find the truth, bro. That simple. You're going to find the truth. We already know what the truth is. You know what I'm saying? Even though we don't want to realize that it is, we already know what the truth is. You dig me? Eminem was talking about all that. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, I'm glad somebody brought it to the forefront because they always trying to say it's Future fault. Future this, Future that. When in reality, this been going on. You feel me? But anyway, if you guys haven't, please like and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate the love, y'all. I'm gone.